from that short commercial break. We still have Momo, and we're looking at how you can make money at your home, or how you can turn farming into a business. You can save money, you can save time by creating a beautiful space in your home where you're going to stay, and then other people come and look for you. Madam Momo, there's a lot that is here. I really need to know, how or what does it take you to have them maintained?
Hilda, we talked about passion and purpose. So my passion was creating a beautiful place. From childhood, I wanted a beautiful place. That was my passion. Now my purpose is to inspire other people to create beautiful spaces. And as I inspire them, I need to explain to them how I do it on a day-to-day basis.
Exactly.
So, you know, these are living things.
True.
They need the care. I have different categories of plants. There are those which need everyday watering. Whether you like it or not, you must water them every day. Then there are those which you do once a week, like these ones, you just do once a week.
Like this?
Yeah. These ones, only once a week. Then there's another type, those ones there on the trunks. Because those ones are not in soil, they are not potted, they need to be watered twice a day, in the morning and in the evening. Only in the hot seasons. When it rains, you don't water. Then we have things like that. It's a cactus. That one doesn't need a lot of water, doesn't need a lot of maintenance. It's like a desert plant.
So how often do
this one do they, we water only once a week.
So are some of your plants that you're having here?
So there are not so many that need too much care. You can see I have balanced them. Yeah, those the ones that need watering every day, they have their category. Then there are those which need watering only once a week. That one surely everyone can do. You water only once a week.
Now the challenge, or the challenging bit actually would be how one may know that this one needs this kind of care. Maybe in a day.
I do that training. If you are interested, then you come and learn how to care for those plants.
Can someone out there come and buy these plants from you?
Sometimes I have them on sale, not regularly, because these are very delicate things. They come from outside. So I sometimes sell them. So when they give me an order, I can get for them.
Now, after, you know, like when you're selling, do you, on that very, very note, do you take your clients through on how?
I would prefer you first learn, get to know all the dynamics of maintenance, and then you come and buy. Because it doesn't make sense for you to buy something when you don't know how you're going to maintain it. And then it might not thrive in your home, and then you say, I've wasted my money. And yet, it's something simple which you can... You know, people don't want to spend time to learn new things. Like I told you, the wheel of life. It's a balance. You have to balance. You need to get information. You need to know. You have to have a network of people so that you are knowledgeable, so that you are thriving and you are happy. In these modern times, well, there are so much, there's a lot of information flowing and people are readily available to share. There's no need for you to be ignorant about something. Don't move in the shop and just pick something and take it home without knowing how.
Out.
Yes. So come to Momo. And Momo will take you through the process of how to maintain, how to manage, which plants to put where, what belongs in the direct sun, what belongs in the shade, what belongs in the air, all that. It's very easy to learn.
Because that's what I even wanted to ask. Because I'm seeing some palms around. Eh? And another person will be like, since it is passion and purpose that we mentioned on our wheel of life, a person will decide that may want a palm on my shed.
Yes, no, you have seen there are some palms in the houses. People have put palms in houses. You restrict them in a container and it grows slowly. So it is what you like, what your eyes feel happy to look at. So you can create anything. Momo can have palms all over. You can have only a few palms. But when you eventually learn the purpose of having trees around you, then you can slowly upgrade and grow more trees. I have seen in pictures people who are in double-storied houses, they have trees growing on terraces. So it's no longer in the ground formula. People are now growing trees in the air. And they've realized trees are important because they give you clean air. They clean the environment. They remove that carbon dioxide which you are breathing out, and then they give you oxygen which they are breathing out, because for them they want the carbon dioxide. So like God said, take care of my creation, he knew we needed to coexist with all these things in nature.
So for the people that have kids, because these are very, like, we hear certain people say things that, you know, I have kids, so I can't buy a certain type of chair. Now, when it comes to these, because I'm seeing vases, they're breakable,
yes.
Flowers are tender. How does one...
I don't have children now, but I have a grandson who comes to visit. But he's trained. From childhood, he's now 3 years. He knows where he can touch and where he cannot touch. Like when he picks a stone there, we allow him to pick the stones. He plays with them and he knows he takes it back to where it belongs. So a child has a capacity to understand, has a capacity to learn. And the learning process starts from birth up to 8 years. That's when they develop habits, that's when they develop behaviors. So you can train your child to love nature and to take care of the nature. You don't scream, you don't shout at them, you just train them, they learn. And they understand, even these dogs of mine, they know where to go, and you have come, you have seen. They cannot pull my plants, no? They'll just come and sniff and go. So I've trained them. He knows where to go.
I want you to elaborate more about the pets and how you tame them to see that they're not littering everywhere. There's a home I went to and all the flowers were being picked on, and I mean, it was a mess.
Yes, you know, these, you bring pets at home when they are still young. Like I told you, a child learns from 0 years to 8 years. The same with a pet. I brought this one when he was 3 months old. So I trained him the toilet, the plants, all that. Even up to now, when he starts, you know, running after like lizards, he sees a lizard there and he wants to run, he's going to knock the pot, you will shout at him, you will say, no, don't go there. Then you will listen. You will understand. So, you know, like I've told you, passion and purpose go together. You want a beautiful garden, that's your purpose, and it is also your passion. So you will make sure everything around you is in conformity with your purpose and passion. and people will buy in. I've told you, you go to a home, the minute you enter and you find garbage.
True.
If you also had a bottle top, you'll throw there in that garbage. Am I lying? Mm-hmm. But if you come with the garbage in your hand, you'll feel embarrassed to litter in my garden. You get it?
Yes.
So that's the training we are talking about. And now the young people, they are the ones we are trying to target so that they create a beautiful world. Let them not only want to go to those beautiful gardens, they should be part of creating the beautiful gardens. That's what we are saying. They should be part of creating those beautiful gardens. Let them not aspire, just admire them out there. But let them be interested, let them participate in creating a beautiful world. I have inspired them and they have all come on board. They have created beauty. You cannot live next to Momo and you have litter in your place.
I know.
That is impossible, it's unheard of. So let's groom, let's encourage, let's inspire so many people, so many young people. They are the ones who will be telling, Mommy, no, stop littering. Because they have now learned the beauty. They have appreciated the beautiful creations. They've appreciated the beautiful environment.
We look about the pest control.
Yes,
how
pest.
Do you control pests from attacking your plants?
They are herbal products. They are natural products,
okay,
which can be used. The neem, the garlic.
Oh, really?
Yes. You soak garlic overnight and then put in neem oil and spray. But if you have those persistent pests, then we have approved organic chemicals on market which you can use. So usually it's best when it is raining, you spray because you get fungus. And then when it starts that hot sun, that's when you have pests producing. You know, they produce a lot in the hot weather. So you spray. So you can do twice a month.
Sorry.
And then I also use organic fertilizers, like this banana peeling. You just throw it there. The shells of the egg, you grind it and then you pour it there. Those are simple things you can use in your home.
So you want to say that, for instance, a shell of an egg is nutritious?
It has calcium, which helps the roots to grow. The banana has magnesium, which helps the leaves to grow. So, but I also complement with other, like
fertilizers.
We have fertilizers which are organic. I also buy and complement with those ones. But I'm usually now using the banana peelings and the eggshell and the garlic. Use the garlic, you soak it overnight and then spray around.
When we look at the pesticides, some people get scared because they may be allergic. You know, they tend to develop that irritation on their skin. So how is it?
Yes, there are some people who are allergic, so you have to first know what you are allergic to, then you get rid of it. Not everything can be allergic. Not everything. And these pests are not destructive to human life. No, they are not destructive. They are these common pests, the aphids, the caterpillars, the snails. Yeah. So they are not.
Sometimes the ants.
Yeah, then those ants. So they are not really dangerous to human beings.
They are not a threat.
They are not a threat. I hear there are some plants that are poisonous, but for me, I don't have any poisonous plant so far. I don't have. You are talking about Valentine. So Valentine has different meanings and interpretations. Bibikrade, it is to remind us the love of God in His creation. God loves us. And remember when I was talking to you in the beginning, how God created the world. So that's the love we need to celebrate. And how do we celebrate it? We celebrate it with family, with friends, with associates. Then there are those who look at it at the romantic part of love, girlfriend and boyfriend, husband and wife. So you can celebrate it at different perspectives. You can celebrate it to remember God's creation with your family. You come together with your friends and celebrate. And like I told you, for me, my home is already pleasant, full of love. So everyone will want to celebrate here with me.
Yes.
And I'm encouraging people to use their homes. Let them make them pleasant. Let them make them happy spaces. And they enjoy their homes. I know they are bored because they are always at home. But you can create something interesting on that day at your home. They can give you a live plant.
To adopt. Because if I received such a plant, the love will be refreshed every other day I look at this plant. And even when I'm taking care of it, it will be out of love. Because Mama has really told us that it is passion that has made her have these many plants. Some of my viewers, our viewers, are there, but they're like, such investment, such places, or such innovations are for the rich. What do you have to say about that?
Hilda, I've told you the wheel of life. We have passion and purpose. So wheel of life, we are looking at faith, we are looking at family, we are looking at finances, we are looking at friends, we are looking at fitness. If you balance all those, whatever category you are, you'll create a beautiful environment. You cannot have a happy life if you don't have a good environment. That one is out completely. I want to confirm it and clarify it. You can never have happiness when you are in a clutter and disorganized. You can never. You must have a good environment. Plant, just a small plant. You don't have to buy all those, you don't need all those expensive plants. Get a plant. There are plants starting from 1,000 shillings. You can have them in your house. You can have them in your compound. You can have them on your balcony. You don't need to have a lot of money. As long as you have passion and you have a purpose of living in a beautiful environment, you'll succeed to achieve something like this. I am there to help anybody who wants to create something beautiful. I will advise you and I will help you to create a beautiful world. You can even bring your children to learn. You can bring everybody, your friends, your family, your associates, anyone who is in your contact can come to me and I will teach them. I'll share the knowledge and information happily. And we shall achieve that purpose, that goal of creating our world, our beautiful world. You have seen my environment. We have a very beautiful world. We have very beautiful spaces. And everybody feels happy coming at home because you know you are coming to a beautiful place.
Thank you very much, our viewers, and to our people that came to the Harvest Money Expo this year under the theme, Farming as a business. We cannot have any word to tell you how special and valuable you are to us. I want to remind our viewers that Urban TV has a promotion. So join the Urban Back to School promotion for a chance to win
100,000 shillings. All you have to do is to send a message to 8008 with a text, Urban TV in capital letters, followed by the reason you would like to win the 100,000 shillings, and tune into Fun Plus at 6:15 p.m. for a chance to win. Once again, from me and my entire crew, we want to say, have a blessed night.